Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about what is Mendeleev's periodic table. So before that, we should know that there were various known peoples who have classified the elements and that have led to the formation of the modern periodic table, and they were known as the Dobinier's, Newlands, as well as Cook's, as well as we have also got to know about Lothar Mayer's contribution in the classification of elements. So now we are going to talk about the main one, that the person which on the basis of which the modern periodic table has been evolved, that is Mendeleev's. And we are now going to talk about Mendeleev's periodic table. So let us talk about that. So now we are going to talk about Mendeleev's periodic table. So Mendeleev have made a very great contribution in the classification of elements, and because of which we have led in a conclusion to form modern periodic table that we are now seeing in our textbooks or in our daily basis when we are talking about it for a science student. But this Mendeleev periodic table that we are going to talk about, it was not a very easy task for him, because the classification of the elements was also necessary along with the chemical properties as well as for their physical properties. And moreover, the contribution of Mendeleev had given an advanced knowledge for us to understand that he had made a prediction for the unknown elements that were being discovered or that were yet to be invented. So he have placed few spaces in the periodic table also, by which it had made his prediction a very rightful thing, so as to describe its periodic table that was being made by him. So let us understand that how he have contributed in the formation of its periodic table. So let us study about that. So Mendeleev used physical and chemical properties of the elements as well as of their several compounds and developed a law known as Mendeleev's periodic law. So Mendeleev have arranged the elements in such a way that they had a basically similar properties, chemical properties, or might have a similar physical properties. So based on these properties, he have arranged the elements, and he had made the arrangement and have made a law that is which stated known as Mendeleev's periodic law. And what does this Mendeleev's periodic law means? Let us study about that also. So the Mendeleev's periodic law states that the physical and chemical properties of elements are the periodic functions of their atomic weight. So the change in physical property or the change in chemical property, that was because of, or the similarities in the chemical property and the physical properties, there were because of the atomic weights of the substance or the atomic weights of the elements. And based on this, he had made this law, which was regarding and concerned towards the atomic weight when it comes to the chemical property or the physical property of the elements. So this was known to be Mendeleev's periodic law. So he arranged the elements in the table consisting of vertical columns that are basically known as groups and horizontal rows basically known as periods. So he had also arranged this manner. So he was the first one to arrange in this manner and having the similar properties when it comes to group and a variation that we could see with respect to the atomic weight in the rows, that is in the periods. So he had made a great contribution in the formation of a periodic table. But now we are going to study about how does he had made those arrangements, and because of which we have seen a revolution thing in the periodic table. So by arranging those elements, he had made a concern that the elements with similar properties were arranged in the same group. So he had made an arrangement in such a manner that the elements which had same properties, might be chemical properties, they were arranged in a same group. So they were arranged in the same group. As well as, he left several gaps in the periodic table, proposing that some of the elements were still undiscovered. So he had also made an arrangement in such a manner that first of all, what we have got to know that the chemical properties are same, and secondly, he had made a few gaps in the periodic table of his periodic table where he had assumed that some elements are yet to be discovered and will be placed in that empty space that it had made for. So let me give an example by showing this diagram. This diagram is nothing the whole experience about the Mendeleev's periodic table, but it consists of few elements that was in the Mendeleev's periodic table. So let us see that. So this is these are those elements which were in the Mendeleev's periodic table. So it starts from the hydrogen, as you could see, hydrogen, helium, beryllium, boron, and this all are said to be in periods, as you could see, while the vertical columns are basically known as the groups. So in this case, he had made several groups and he have named those groups as, for hydrogen, helium and till rubidium, he had made the group known as group 1, and again for this it had made group 2, then it moved to 3, then 4, then 5, 6, 7, and this group were called to be group 8. But these are the 8 groups that the, he had made so as to classify the chemical properties based on the atomic weight. And but talking about the next thing, that after that the helium, neon, means the noble gas, were also been were discovered, and because of which he had made those groups to be called as group 0, which was placed here, as you could see at the extreme left of the Mendeleev's periodic table, and on that position helium, neon, or those noble gases have been placed. So therefore totally it makes the Mendeleev periodic table to have actually 9 groups, and originally this was the one which had 8 groups, and talking about the periods, it consisted of 12 periods, but in this diagram I am showing only few periods, as you could see. But the, talking about the next point, that the first point that it was explaining, that he have arranged the elements in such a manner that they have, will have similar properties with respect to the group. So this all would have the similar properties, as we could see in the group. So he had arranged in that manner, and moreover you could see that there are empty spaces. So this empty spaces was being predicted by the Mendeleev, that some elements will take the position in this empty spaces, and that was being true also. And but what does this empty space were called? So let us talk about that also. So this elements were being called, as we could see, that the gap that we could see below aluminium and below silicon, it was called to be eka aluminium or eka silicon. So as you could see here, this space below the aluminium, as you could see, these are known as eka aluminium, while the gaps that are below the silicon, as you could see, that would be called as eka silicon. So this where we named that some elements would come and will take the place over here. So I just generalized here, just generalized the name as eka aluminium and eka silicon, so which would be based or which would be placed here. So this gaps that was not being filled when the Mendeleev's periodic table was being made, but after that we have got to know that the gaps were filled after the discovery of gallium and germanium. So in this space, basically, as you could see, that this space was being occupied by the gallium and germanium. So this prediction was a very great influence in understanding that how Mendeleev have made a great announcement in basically classifying those elements, as well as this prediction of him made him famous, that because of which the modern periodic table, as we could see now, it's all because of him, the prediction that he have made. And talking about the next one, at some places in the periodic table which was made by him, he ignored the increasing order of atomic weight and placed the other elements with similar properties together. For example, iodine with lower atomic weight than tellurium was placed in group 7. As you could see, that in group 7, as you could see, that the iodine which was which is not been mentioned here, but the iodine which was been placed, it was been placed lower to that of the tellurium, and that was belonging to the group 7. So that was the thing that he had made a prediction. And moreover, we could see that when it comes to group 7, we could see that fluorine, chlorine and that iodine, they all are basically halogens, and that's the reason they are kept in the same group. But moreover, he had didn't made a concern towards at some places in increasing order of the atomic weight. He had just made a placement of those elements in his periodic table depending on the property. So this was basically the Mendeleev's periodic table that I was talking about, and because of which it had made a great influence. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video that how Mendeleev have played a very important role and what are its importance when it comes to the periodic table of Mendeleev. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you'll share this video, and yes, you'll not forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.